What's up, guys? Today, I'm going to show you how to make this YouTube subscribe animation in Apple Motion. This animation is inspired by the new Motype titles pack from FxFacotry. If you saw my plugins video last week, you know that I went absolutely gaga for this pack of titles. These titles from FxFacotry are amazing. And today we're gonna replicate these ones here in this style, the 3D long shadows. I really do love this look. Now, as a reminder, all of the members on my Patreon get access to my working files in Apple Motion. So hop on over there after you watch this tutorial so you can really dig into my working files. And if you really want a good understanding of Apple Motion, you really want to master it, check out my course, Motion Launchpad. I will link to that down below. All right, you guys, let's just dive right into the tutorial. All right, so here is the project browser in Motion. I am going to use the preset of 4K, 24 frames per second, and my project duration is 6 seconds. Let's just open this guy up. All right, the first thing we're going to do is reach for the text tool. I am going to just type in the word like in all capital letters. In the inspector window, let's format this guy here. The font is Avenir Next, and I'm going to make this bold. I'm gonna crank up the size all the way up to 288. And I'm just gonna push this guy right here to the center of the screen. All right, next up, we're going to add the extrude filter to get those like long shadows on our text. You can find the extrude filter up here at the top of the screen under the stylize category. Or of course, you can just go down to the library and search within the filters for extrude. All right, in the inspector window, let's make some big changes here. The first thing we wanna do is crank up that distance. Now, if I use the slider, it only takes me to 100, but if I click on this 100 value here, hold down my mouse key and push upward with my mouse, I can actually go all the way up to 500, but only 500. Now let's take this back size all the way down to 0. And we get that point that we're looking for. Now to find our perfect angle, I'm going to head on over to my canvas, and with these on-screen controls, I'm going to find my angle, bringing it toward the bottom right corner. Now to get this extrude to elongate, I'm going to grab my text and drag it all the way to the top left of my canvas, and then I might fine-tune the angle a little bit like so. All right, now let's customize the look of these shadows here. Under the extrude style, I wanna go from shading to gradient. Now under the gradient, I wanna make this a solid color. So I'm going to select the first color tag here and choose the color I want this to be. In this case, I'm going to make it orange. And then to make this all one solid color, I'm just going to take this other color tag, this white one here. I'm gonna select it, click it, and drag it away. So now my gradient has really just become one solid color, sort of. You can see there is a little bit of variation in the shadow from where it's really close to the letters, and it does get darker at the tip of the back end of my shadows. So now what I'm going to do is play with the front and back brightness till I feel like they're a little more even. All right, that looks good to me, but how do we get this text in the bottom right corner? You might think, well, Jen, you just grab it and drag it to the right corner, but that doesn't really work with the extrude filter. There's a bit of a hack I'm going to show you. Let me first show you what the problem is, which is that if I grab the text, the extrude stays pinpointed down here in my screen. And what I really want is for this text to come up from the bottom right corner. So what we're going to do is grab this text on the group level. Now moving the group still doesn't solve our problem, but watch what does. I'm gonna check this box here for fixed resolution. And now I can treat my text as all one element and place it where I see fit. Now let's add some animation to this text and bring it to life. So I'm going to select the text in my project pane, head on up to behaviors. We're gonna go down to text basic behaviors, and we're going to select drift in. And by default, let me just show you what it does. It fades in and it drifts to the right. This is not what we want. What I'm going to do here is head on over to my inspector window and expand the format. The first thing I want is to change the direction from which the text is animating. I really want it to come from this bottom right corner. So I'm going to use my on-screen controls here and reposition the start point of this text. All right, I feel pretty good about that. The next thing I want to do is make sure the text does not fade in. So what I'm going to do is change this opacity value all the way up to 100. Now let's go down to my controls. Under sequencing, we're going to leave it on from. Under animate, we're going to go to character. And on the spread, I'm going to crank this up to a value of about 8. So here's what our animation looks like thus far. I think it's happening too slow. So I'm going to grab the edge of my drift in behavior down here in my timeline. Let's bring it to a value of 20 frames. Now on the speed, let's change this to custom and then open up our keyframe editor, change the interpolation of these keyframes to Bezier. And then I'm going to grab these handles here and really exaggerate the movement. Now we have to think about how this text is going to animate out. I'm going to add a drift out behavior to the end of this text. So again, make sure we're selected on it. Behaviors, text, basic, drift out. Now the drift out defaults to the beginning of my text element. So I'm going to drag it to the end of the timeline and change the duration to about 20 frames. Again, by default, it floats out to the right. So again, I'm going to use the on-screen controls. This time I'm going to have the text fly straight down out of frame. I want to get rid of that fade out. So I'm going to again, crank the opacity all the way up to 100. And as far as the rest of the controls, I do want the entire word to fall out together. So I'm just going to leave those as they are. Now we just need to add the other lines in our animation. To do this, I'm going to duplicate my entire group, not just the text. So select that group in the project pane, hit Command D to duplicate it. Let's modify our text. This one's going to say subscribe. Now you can see my text is getting cropped off. Don't you worry. I am going to offset the text on the X value, select the group in my project pane and just reposition it. Let's head over to the extrude filter on this line of text. And I'm just going to play with the angle of the extrusion a little bit so it matches the angle of my original text. And let's change the color of our long shadow. I'm gonna select this pink. And one more time, let's duplicate that group, modify the text. Once again, I'm going to modify the X position and then select the group and reposition my text. On the extrude filter, again, I'm just going to play with that angle a little bit and let's change the color. All right, now that I've changed the color, I can see that the extrude on this guy is not really going quite at the angle I want it to. It's not really matching the other two as well. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to select that text and I'm going to move the text to an angle that I feel like best fits the other lines of text that we have. Now you see that my text is actually getting cropped off there. So what I'm going to do is reduce the size of that text in my inspector window under the text tab under format, but then I'm going to select the group layer, head on over to properties and scale it up just a bit to match the rest of my text size. All right, and the last thing we wanna do is just sort of play with the timing of all of these elements. I don't want them all to happen at the same time. So what I'm first going to do is start with the out animations to retime these guys. I want the ring the bell line to drop out of frame first before subscribe and like. So I'm going to take that drift out behavior and just bring it forward a little bit in my timeline. And then I'm going to take the drift out behavior on the subscribe line and bring that forward as well. And the like I'm going to leave in place. And once I've got that animation in place, I'm just going to trim the actual text in the timeline so it doesn't hang out over the behavior. And we're going to do the same thing for the drift in behaviors at the beginning of our timeline. So the like I wanna keep at the very beginning of it, my animation, the subscribe's gonna come in a little later, and the ring the bell's gonna come in a little later than that. And again, once I've got my timing right, I'm just gonna trim those endpoints. And the finishing touch to this animation is to make some adjustments to the drift in behaviors on my subscribe line and my ring the bell line. Because these lines have more characters, I want to increase the spread a little bit accordingly. So let's first start with the subscribe text. I'm going to select the drift in on that one and let's crank up the spread a little bit to 20. And then on the ring the bell, this has even more characters. So I'm going to go all the way up to 30. And then of course, to export this guy, you're going to want to make sure that you're choosing the video codec Apple ProRes 4444. That's going to give you the transparent background you need to overlay your animation over live action video for your YouTube videos. Remember, if you want the working file, check out my Patreon community. If you want to deep dive into Apple Motion and really master it, you need Motion Launchpad, which you can grab at jenjager.com. Thank you so much to FxFacotry and Motype 2 for the inspo today. If you want to check out that title pack, I will drop it in the description box below. It is amazing. I picked out some other videos I know you're gonna love, and I'll see you again.